Hello and welcome to our yin yoga class. My name is Tammy. Let's scooch back to our mat. We are focusing on yin yoga for our soul. So sitting in easy pose and notice which leg that is crossing in front right now. And then you can do a little shift through your body. So yin yoga for our soul is emotional and intellectual energy. So just going to just do some brushing of our legs right here. So you can just bring your arms to the top and then down your shins. And then just fold and then brushing down your arms. Just a few times here, just waking up our body. So, being aware how we're feeling, you can do some squeezing of your legs. And then sitting in easy pose, nice and tall, turn your palms up towards the sky. You may have a mudra. Your mudra could be with your thumb, index finger, middle finger, your ring finger, or pinky. What would you like to do? What feels good for you right now? So these, a mudra is a hand gesture. So what is feeling good? And try out each of your fingers. Then you may close your eyes and let your body soften. Now I want you to just feel from head to toe how you are doing in your physical body. Where is your mind at? Your thoughts? How is your energy? Have you had a chance to find calm, stillness in your day? This may be the first opportunity that you've had to be still. If it is, you could have still very high energy. Maybe you're tired though. So this class, yin yoga, will be so good for us to be able to waken up our body, but not to the point that we feel that we need to be doing something after. But in a way that we are able to be present and aware. Now we open up our eyes and release our mudra. And uncrossing your legs and crossing your legs the opposite way, back into easy pose, making our way in towards a twist. Now we sit up nice and tall with a nice inhale breath, and we twist over to our one of our sides. You may look over the shoulder and breathe. Now coming into a twist at first, you may notice that opening up through the front of the body or the back of the body may be a little bit awkward at first, but as we sit in this pose for a little bit longer, we're able to come into a deeper twist. focusing on your breath, being aware how we're feeling. Are we able to let our shoulders soften now and let go? Coming out of the twist with the exhale breath, we slowly make our way back towards the center. And uncrossing your legs and crossing your legs the opposite way. And then into the twist for the other side. And we sit up nice and tall with an inhale breath and rotating towards the other side with the exhale breath. You may let your eyes soften, close, but still being present, aware, noticing the twist into the spine. Over soften. Making our way out of the twist with the exhale breath. Come back to the center. Digging our feet, bottom of our feet together, making our way to butterfly. And we sit up tall with an inhale breath, exhale breath, folding forward. Your arms may come forward. You may turn your palms up towards the sky. Let them rest here for your hands. Let your head release and let go. Inhale breath, making your way back up. And exhale breath, we take both of those legs in front and take your feet wider than the knees, windshield wiper, knees side to side. Now you may be playing some nice calming music for yourself here. And we release. Coming into swan pose. If swan pose does not work for you, I'm just going to show you an option first. It is figure four, lying on your back, crossing your ankle over top, threading the needle, and you may hold that. You may also sit on a chair and then cross your ankle over the opposite knee. And counting all fours, if you want to make your way into swan with me, step forward with the right hand, left hand, and into downward facing dog. three-legged dog. So you're on the balls of the feet, three-legged dog. Right leg lifts up towards the sky. Now bend through the knee and bring your knee forward and turn it out to the right wrist. And we hold here. You may be in swan being upright. My right left toes are down right now to help square my hips. If you would like to lower into sleeping swan, you may uncurl the toes, and then that way you're able to sink your pelvis into the ground a little bit deeper. You may let the forehead rest. Could be resting on your hands. Could be resting on the ground and let yourself settle. We're in sleeping swan for just a little longer. We can slowly start now to make our way out of swan. If you are in figure four, you can release. Now coming back to downward facing dog from sleeping swan and then into the next side. So on the balls of the feet, three-legged dog, left leg lifts, bend through the knee and bring your knee forward and turn out to left wrist. And then if you're lying on your back, you are crossing your left ankle over top the right. Now, all these lovely poses that are holding for longer periods of time, you may start to hear noises in your body. So it could be digesting food in your intestines and just letting it happen. You may come into sleeping swan. You may uncurl the toes. If you find, yes, my hips, they're square, and I can get my hips down just a little bit more, letting the forehead rest to help you to feel grounded. Letting our energy settle, having that nice calm energy within us. Knowing yourself, how you're feeling, How are you able to come back to your true self, to feel harmony, balance, peace? Yes, yoga is a wonderful way to do that. We can turn our attention to our breath. And enjoying this moment of being still. Just notice if one side of the hip is similar to the other. Then coming out of swan pose, or figure four pose, and make your way back to downward facing dog, and then everyone coming down to a seated pose into a side bend for us. Okay, back to our seated pose and crossing one leg over the other for easy pose. And then lifting up one arm and up and over, we come into a side bend with an exhale breath. We hold. You may bring your forearm down towards the ground. You may add a little rotation. And let your top arm just hang here. Inhale breath, making our way back up. Exhale, taking your hand down into our other side. Inhale, sweep your arm up overhead. And exhale, coming up and over to the side bend. Now, again, you just let the arm dangle. You may turn your head. You can come down to the forearm. Close your eyes. The inhale breath, feel the expansion of your chest, Your belly opening up. Now into the rib cage, opening. We feel the rise and fall. And inhale breath, drawing us back to upright. And exhale breath. We draw the arm down. Melting heart for our next pose. If you wanted to double up your mat or have something under the knees too for melting heart, you may. So into all fours here first. And then melting heart with a big step forward with the right hand, left hand. Draw the forearms down, your hips right over top of the knees, and now letting the front of the body sink down, forehead resting. Coming out of melting heart and sitting back first into child's pose for a moment, a little counter pose. Your arms may be forward or they may be by the side of the body. You may turn your knees out to the sides of your mat or your knees are forward. Being kind to yourself as we move through the poses. Knowing that it may take a little while for our body, our physical body, to release. Being okay to be in a pose for a longer period of time, to be able to sit with our thoughts, knowing that they could be uncomfortable at times, using our breath to breathe through these moments. Into our next pose, which is Sphinx pose, so coming onto the front of our body, and we are prone, so the front of our body, and forearms down, and your elbows are underneath of your shoulders. Now, here we draw our upper body up, pulling, drawing, lifting your tail, your navel towards your spine. Thinking of ice cubes underneath of your navel, so lifting up, getting away from the back hold. Now, so our shoulders don't take all the weight. We're not just pressing down with our elbows. I want you to press down with your hands. So with your hands pressing down in Sphinx pose, You may release your head so it hangs, and then that's going to help take pressure off your neck. And then slowly lifting our head and coming out of Sphinx. We hold child's pose again just for a moment here. And then come out into the next pose, which is tadpole. Now, tadpole is opening up into our inner thighs. Now, this may not be work for everyone. I'm just going to show you this way. So I'm going to turn towards the front here. I'm having my toes turned out like that. Okay, so in tadpole, have your toes turned out to the side. And then it's the same idea as melting heart. So taking your knees wider than the hips, turn your toes out, and then come down to the forearms. And then just hold. If you wanted to open up your legs wider, that would be into frog. So tadpole, the smaller version. And let the head just release down. You can let the forehead rest onto the ground, your hands, so just turn your elbows up. The inside of your feet pressing down into the ground. And coming out of tadpole. And release and sitting down onto your bottom. Okay, into our next pose, we're stretching into our hamstrings here. If you have your blocks handy, you may use your blocks. Three different heights for your blocks. It could be here's the shortest, medium height, and then the tall. Okay, so just playing with it too to see what you would like to do. So if you have it at the shortest, okay, we're taking our right leg forward. Now I can have my block, so I'm resting my hands, palms of my hands, my fingers are pointing down, and I'm gonna sit back. Drawing my toes back, flexing my foot. So draw the toes towards your face and notice your spine. Are you able to come over with a flat back? Now, is this a good height for you? Maybe you want it on the middle height. What is the right height? And we're breathing. Let your exhale breath help you to sit a little bit deeper. Help you to let your shoulders soften. And coming out of this hamstring stretch, we're going to take our leg back and then into the other side. Take your left leg forward. And again, we have that flat back instead of grounded. So, not worrying about how deep that you're going to come into this. If you are rounding through the spine, just coming up a little bit more. And this is when you can change your blocks or whatever that you have here for support too. So of course you could use other things. You could use pillows for support. And we're breathing. Shoulder softening. And coming out of our hamstring stretch, take your leg back and into child's pose. So just placing your blocks over to the side for yourself and then into child's pose. Now child's pose, this one, having our hands forward. You may have your knees turned out a bit towards the side. Now walking our hands over towards the right side. So I'm going to move my body so you can see me. And walking the hands over, let the forehead rest. And all along the sides of our body, we're feeling this opening, this stretch, sitting back into those heels. And slowly coming out of our side bend, and we come back towards the center and then to the other side. Now, child's pose is definitely one of my favorites for really noticing the breath, noticing how you're breathing. Feel like the forehead rests. Really noticing how the breath is moving, opening up your body. Is it an even breath? Are we able to breathe into the front, the sides, the back of our body? And coming out, we lift our head, come back towards the center and making our way up. We have shoelace pose for our next pose. And this is when you could use a pillow here. And for shoelace pose, take your legs both forward, remove the fleshy part from your bottom. Cross your right leg over top of the left leg, like that. If you wanted to have a pillow underneath of the right knee, you may. Okay, so that's how we would be able to use our pillow here. Or, shoelace, the full version would be having both of the knees bent. You may hold on to your knees here, just where it's comfortable on the shins, or holding on to your ankles. Let your shoulders soften and we breathe. Notice both sides of both of your hips. How are we feeling in this pose? Letting your mind know it is okay to let go here. Soften. Coming out of shoelace, crossing. We now move to the other side. If you wanted to wiggle a little windshield wiper of the knee side to side first, you may, having your feet wider than the hips, we do the windshield wiper. And then into the other side. Taking both legs long again, remove the fleshy part from your bottom, crossing your left ankle and then the knee over top. So you can have knee over top. You may have your support underneath of the knee. Yes, you can be right there. Or bending both of the knees. The goal is to have the knees stacked over top of each other. You may hold on to whatever is comfortable for you, ankles, if you like. Now we tell our body to soften, to let go. Knowing that our mind is very strong and very powerful, and that by telling our body to soften, it will start to be able to let go, start to release. There's nothing that we need to hold on to. Tell yourself to let go just a little bit more. Let go of your shoulders, let them just fall. Shoelace, take the hands behind, crossing. Here you may come with me back into windshield wiper, knees, and a release. Our next pose is reclined butterfly. Now, with reclined butterfly, you can have your pillows ready for support underneath of the knees. Now, we did butterfly a little bit earlier here. And let's also stir up. We didn't have the support underneath of our knees. We didn't hold it for as long of a period of time. But here we will hold it for a few minutes. If you want to lie on a pillow, a couch cushion, something that is firmer, you can do that. So what I would do is tuck my hips in nice and close, and then roll over. So if you don't want a cushion, you don't have to lie on anything. Now my knees are up towards the sides, and then I'm going to place my pillows. Knees are up towards the side. And then place my pillows underneath where my knees would go, and then let my knees turn out. Bottom of my feet, they are touching. Now, where would you like your hands? Now, if you want to open up a little bit more in towards the front of the body, bring your arms over, open towards sides. And here is wonderful for opening up through the front of the body with your breath. I want you to feel your breath rising into your armpits, into the back of the body. I want you to feel that this opening creating happiness for yourself.
And once again, we tell ourselves, our physical body, to soften once again. Coming out of our reclined butterfly pose. Yes, sadly. Okay, we're taking one knee up and then the other knee up. And then rolling over to your side and making your way back up. Okay, our next pose is Banana Asana. So it's also a really lovely pose. So our lovely pose is not coming to an end. And coming over to your back. Taking your legs straight. And walking your legs over to the right corner of the mat, and then upper body walking over to the right corner of the mat. Now you may hold the banana shape right here, or you're bringing your arms overhead and then holding onto your hands or opposite elbows. You may cross your left ankle over top of the right and hold. And we're long through both sides of the waist when we do this. The focus is on opening up through the left side of the body first. And coming out of a banana shape this side, across your ankles, releasing your arms back down to the side and taking your body back towards the center and then walking your legs over to the left corner of your mat. Upper body first, walking over left corner. Upper body is set, and then bringing your arms overhead. You may cross your right ankle over top of the left. And the focus is on opening up through the right side of our body. Coming out of Banana Asana, we uncross our ankles. We release our arms back. Take our upper body back towards the center, lower body back towards the center. Now, our last pose, Shavasana. So coming into Shavasana, it's also called pentacle. You may be on your back. Your knees may be bent. You could have your knees bent and have a blanket underneath of your knees for support. When your knees are bent or if there's something underneath of your knees, it does take pressure off the lower back. So you may want to do that. You could have your legs straight and taking one and then the other ankle to each corner of your mat. You may have your arms open, the sides of the body. You may be lying on one side of the body or sitting in a comfortable seated pose for yourself. Now, whatever you choose, we find stillness. And we let our self be aware. Letting herself enjoy this moment to be able to release, let go, letting her thoughts pass one by one. Their eyes closed. We let the lips part to help her facial muscles soften, shoulders soften. A natural breath. We let herself be. We'll call you back when it is time.
Slowly starting to come back. Once again, noticing the breath. Maybe temperature. Is it hot, warm, cold? Hopefully warm. And feeling this warmth from the inside out for yourself. Wiggling your toes, wiggling your fingers. It's starting to come back a little bit more. Maybe a shift through the body. And now if you're lying on your back, you bend one knee, then the other knee. Taking your right arm overhead and rolling over to your right side to fetal. And then making your way back up. Comfortable seated position. You may be sitting with your hips higher than the knees too. And then taking your hands to your heart center. Close your eyes for a moment. I want you to just feel the energy from the inside out. Feeling calm. Feeling clarity in mind and body. Feeling balanced in our emotions. And opening up our eyes. Thank you very much for joining me. Sharing your practice. Namaste.